Tuesday, March 30th. Praise the Lord for another Tuesday.
Living this kind of life.
I thought I'd start us out with a little bit of praise today. And that's the song that's playing is Living by the Clark Sisters. I love the Clark Sisters. How many of you like living a blessed life? Hey, 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 Lolo. You living that best life, girl? Yes.
I'm living a blessed life.
Yes.
They will be moved. I can speak to dreams.
Come on now.
They will come true. I can tell my troubles.
Oh, yes. Come on in. Tag somebody.
To make my day. I'm no longer walking. I'm just standing resting.
It's a beautiful, cloudy day here. Day is like. I hope you all are having a great day so far.
Every day I'm living
all my life. Yes, yes, he is, Lois. He's always outside. A little bit of praise today. Come on now. Let's praise him today. Yes. Yes. Come on now. Praise the Lord. Yes. Yes. Hi, Charlene. Thank you for joining me. Yes. How many of y'all know y'all living a blessed life? I love this song. You know, I like to start out praising God before we get into everything. So we don't go on like into this. Yes. Yes. I love it when she do that part right there. Welcome to Testimony Tuesday. Today is Tuesday, March 30th. My name is Anita J. Merchant. I am known as the Prayer Advocate. I'm a certified prayer intercessor, and I am sold out to prayer. I live prayer. I breathe prayer. I talk prayer. I walk prayer. I preach about, teach about my prayer. My conversation always involves something about prayer. Hey, Brunetta down there in New Orleans, hi. And so today, on Testimony Tuesday, you know I like to give away something. You know I like to shout out to some of our women. You know, so today we're going to shout out to three people today. The first person we're going to shout out, because you know this is National Women's Month and it's about to wrap up. So my next Testimony Tuesday won't be in this month. So I thought I would shout out to three African-American women who are doing their thing out there in the world. So my first person that I want to shout out to, and by the way, she is the sponsor of the giveaway today, and I'm going to go into that a little in a few minutes about what you need to do to win the giveaway. But I want to shout out to Dolores Johnson White, who has recently formed an LLC, Exotic Creations. Look her up on the website or the social media or whatever. If you need contact information, you can DM me. But again, I want to shout out to her. She's starting her entrepreneurship life where she's going to see how wonderful it is. So I want to say congratulations to you, Lois. I know in the background the hard work you've done to get where you are. And as I keep on reminding you, God does not sleep, and he is definitely not a slumber. He comes just when you need it to. So congratulations on your LLC. And look, the sky's the limit. You're going to get ready to soar. The next person I want to send a shout out to is, she like my bonus daughter, because you know I don't have any daughters. I want to give a shout out to Kyla Trotter, who is also a new and upcoming entrepreneur who has her LLC, and the name of her business is Problematic Media Group. She does photography, she does graphics, all those things. And so I want to send a shout out to Kyla. She may not be listening at this. She may be still in bed knowing Kyla. But anyway, I want to send a shout out to her. She's a millennial entrepreneur who is starting out, stepping out on faith and just doing her thing. And to Kyla, I want to say, you're going to soar. You're going to do marvelous, wonderful things. So just keep your head up. Keep looking forward. And last but not least, I want to give a shout out to my niece, Ingrid Johnson, who is an attorney and been an attorney for a long time. But she also is a very big community advocate. She's a very big community sponsoring person in our hometown in Alexandria, Louisiana. She is always doing things for the children. She has a heart for young women, young girls, little girls. She just has a heart of always giving. So I want to send a shout out to her. She's an attorney, very good attorney. So if you need an attorney, give her a call. You can look her up on the Ingrid Johnson. So I want to send a shout out to her. Okay, so last week winners, I need to share them and their names. So last week winners was for the book and the journal. You remember I was giving away a Michelle Obama book and journal, the Becoming book that Michelle Obama wrote. By the way, if you don't have the book, you need to get the book, okay? So the winner for that is Sabrina Hickerson. She's out of New Orleans, Louisiana. So I've made contact with her to get her giveaway from last week. And then my next giveaway was the prayer box that's going to include all things prayer. You know, I'm just sold out to prayer. So all things prayer. And the winner of that prayer box is Lula Johnson. She lives in Alexandria, Louisiana. And so I'm going to send that box to her. So congratulations to our last week winner giveaways. Okay, so here's what I want to give away today. And listen to this and make a note, okay? I want to give away today a really nice tote bag. Again, who is being sponsored by Exotic Creations, the new entrepreneur that I talked about earlier. I want to give that away. But here's what you're going to have to do to be able to receive this giveaway for this week. You're going to have to post the scripture I read while I am live. Now, y'all know every time I come to you with a word, I come back and show you where it's in the word. And so today's giveaway, in order to win today's giveaway, you have to quote the scripture on your page and then tag me and share with 5 people. I'm going to repeat that one more time. You have to quote the scripture, write it on your page. You have to tag me and tag 5 people. I will go back through and see who has done this, and you will be given the giveaway that is sponsored again by Exotic Creations for this week. So we've got all of that behind ourselves. Let's get to the topic. So today's topic, if you saw my post earlier, you will see, hey, my cousin Brenda, you will see where I post about what time do you pray? I want you to think about that. What time do you pray? Now, ask this question at the beginning because some of you may realize you are not praying enough. Some of you may realize you're only praying when you need something. Some of you may realize you are only praying just because you're going through the motions because people say you need to pray. Some of you may already know what time to pray, when you pray, how to pray, why you pray, and all of that. But for those who don't, I wanted to just share with you, because after all, I'm the prayer advocate, so I'm sold out to prayer, me. I wanted to share with you today and ask that question, what time do you pray? Now, we all could say we pray all the time, and we know that's not humanly true, right? But what we can say is this, that we may have short prayers that we pray throughout the day, or a short prayer before we're about to encounter something, or a short prayer when we need God like immediately to make a shift in our life about something, or a short prayer when we need to pray real quick, whatever the circumstances may be for you. What time do you pray? Here's where I want to challenge you, and you ask yourself this question, even when we're done with this, ask yourself when you get off of this live session, when do I pray? What time do I pray? How often do I pray? Why do I even know why do I pray? Ask yourself those questions, because we're going to go on a little bit more in some future series about why you pray, how to pray, do you need to pray, and all those things. But today, I want us to focus on what time do you pray? Now, I'm sharing this with you because a lot of times we get caught up on worrying about what somebody else say we need to do, or the way we need to do it, or we get caught up on if somebody know if we pray or if we don't pray. Keep this in mind. What time do you pray is between you and God. It's not between you and anyone else. But at the same token, what time do you pray is something that you individually, this is a individually commitment between you and God. It's not about a commitment between you and the church you affiliated with. It's not about the commitment between you and your pastor. It's not about the commitment between you and your cousins, your sister, your friends, your mama, whoever you want to call it. That is not, it's not between the two of them and you. It's between you and God. Now remember, God knows everything. Don't get caught up in thinking that he doesn't see your heart and he doesn't know your mind. I thought I would say that because we have a lot of people who will profess with their mouth, who will open their mouth and say that they pray all the time. Now think about that. It really depends on your commitment and your relationship with God to determine how much you're going to pray, when you're going to pray, the way you're going to pray. I could sit here all day and talk about prayer, what you should do, how you can do it, what to do to get answers, how to get the effective prayer. Like, you know, all those things. We got books about effective prayer, how to pray, what to go to God with and all that. But when you really think about it, at the end of the day, it's between you and God. Your prayer life is your commitment between you and God. Your prayer life is not about how long you pray, not so much about the words you choose, and it's not even about being a powerful prayer person that pray out loud real good, you know, get all the words right and all that. Don't get caught up in that. And that's where we fall short and we lose focus, that our relationship with God is between us, you, me, and God. It's not between your prayer partner and you. It's not between your husband and you. It's really not between your children and you. Your personal prayer life is between you and God. And so I wanted to come on today and just kind of touch about that, because a lot of people use the excuse that they don't pray because for whatever reason. I want to say today, there should never be an excuse in your life that prevents you from praying. You can pray walking in the streets. You can pray on the phone. You can pray in your closet. You can pray driving down the street. You can pray on the phone when you're gossiping instead of gossiping. Say, hey girl, let's come together and pray. How about that? You can pray sitting still, not moving, and people don't even know you're praying. So see, God has made it so possible. Come on, Holy Spirit. For us to have opportunity to communicate with him, to pray, to open up our mouths and say what we need to say to him, to keep that relationship combined and packed and folded with him through prayer. So we really have no excuse. You know, I hear a lot of people say when I ask the question, why do you think your prayer life is the way that it is? Well, girl, I don't have time. Girl, them kids. Girl, my husband. Girl, the job. All those excuses, it's let's call it what it is. It's an excuse. It's nothing else. It's an excuse. It's an excuse. It's an excuse. And just like we make time for anything else. I'm going to put that out there. We make time to scroll on social media. Hello, Lord. We make time to call and gossip. Come on, Lord. We make time to get up, make sure we clock in that clock on the job on time. We do all of those things, and we don't have no excuses when it comes to doing those things. But when we talk about the prayer life and about praying to God and praying and consistently praying, we have a lot of excuses. So I want to encourage you today. Let's create what they call, I have some prayers that I call breath prayers that I pray throughout the day, that I talk to God and I speak to God and I ask God and I give God my attention throughout the day. Not saying I'm perfect. Oh no, I'm not going to claim that. But throughout the day, I have little small breath prayers with God. I'll stop in my tracks and I will breathe and say a prayer to God. Lord, you are my God. Something simple. They don't have to always be long and drawn out. They don't have to always include a lot of correct language and words. They don't even have to be loud and verbose. You can just walk around through your house. You can be sitting at the red light in your car. You can be sitting right next to your spouse. You could be brushing your teeth. There is so many ways that you can have a little prayer time with God that where you have no excuse. I don't ever use an excuse about why I can't pray. I don't. Even when I don't feel like praying, I open up my mouth and I say, Lord, you know I'm tired today, but I'm coming to you today just as I am. All God wants is a communication relationship with you. And we know any communication that you have in a relationship helps the relationship be successful. I don't know about you, but I pray daily asking God to help me keep a great relationship with him, to help me keep an open chain of communication with him, to help me open my mouth and just call him just to say, thank you, Lord. That's a breath prayer. Lord, I can breathe today. Hallelujah. You know how I am about the breathing thing. Just something just as simple as that. And so when we find ourselves giving excuses about what time do you pray, stop in your tracks and ask God to help you with your time with him, to help you with prayer, help you know how to pray, help you to know what to pray, why you're praying. Just ask him. And I promise you, he's going to give you the answer. But we first have to take ourselves and use the time to pray to him every day. Not some days, not when our back is up against the wall, not when we want the new car, not when we want him to bless us with the house, not when we want him to bless us with our children acting right. You know, we don't have a problem going to him with all those things. But how about having a day of just thanking him? Lord, thank you that I got a roof over my head. Or Lord, thank you for loving me, a sinner, the way that I am. Thank you for creating me. How about that? Thank you, Lord, for being able to allow me to see. Just little things. Just thank him. Have some thank you days. Don't always have a prayer day where you going to him, begging him for stuff and asking him for stuff and telling him to fix stuff and that you want this and you want that. Just say thank you today, Lord. When your feet hit the floor, you can have a prayer time with God. Lord, you woke me up this morning. Thank you. Lord, oh, my feet can touch the floor. Lord, I got all the my limbs working. Oh, Lord. See, we take the little things for granted. And we think we're only supposed to go to him for the big stuff. God wants you for everything, not just the big stuff. So I'm encouraging you today. Take some time. Ask yourself the question, what time do I pray? Just ask yourself the question, what time do I pray? And think about it. Get in some quiet alone time and ask God, God, am I praying enough? God, am I coming to you for everything? God, am I doing it? Just ask him. But the way you're going to be able to do that is you got to have a consistent prayer life. Communication. It's a two-way street. When you praying to him, slow down and listen to what he has to say. He has a lot to say every day. Blesses. Thank you, Lord. He has a lot to say all the time. Thank you, Lord. But we need to get into that position in life, in our individual lives, because our relationship, as I stated earlier, is between us and God. We need to get into a position, change your life, whatever way you have to. If you haven't been praying frequently enough, if you haven't been going to him enough, if you haven't been talking to him enough, shift your life, change your lifestyle. Whatever your lifestyle is, it's not too important to have your time with him, to open up your mouth and have some breath prayers. That's what I call breath prayers. Lord, what do you want me to do today, Jesus? I'm talking to him. I'm praying to him. See, people think that you got to be on your knees. You got to be wailing and crying and screaming and hollering all out on the floor. You know, you got to be doing that all the time. That's not what he asked of you. He just asked your time. He just asked you to be consistent. That's all. If there's a day that you do have, because if you've been living as long as me, I've had some wailing days where I have been straddled the floor, where tears have been flowing, not just for sadness, but for joy. So sometimes my prayer days are deep, you know. Sometimes my prayer days are a little longer than others. Sometimes my prayer time is short and quick. But I do it throughout the day to remind God, I know you are with me. I know who you are. I am grateful for you. I am so appreciative of you. Just the little things. Speak to him. He's waiting. He's waiting for you to shift and change your life. He's waiting. And it's so simple how we will sit and wait on people. Now, this might kind of like, you know, rub a little few people wrong. How we will sit around and wait on people. Still don't get the results we want, but we will wait on them, and we will wait on them, and we will wait on them. Why we can't do that for God? Just wait for God. Just wait on him. Let him not have to always wait. You waiting because say, Lord, I need you today. Well, Lord, today you blessed me with food in the refrigerator. Simple stuff. You don't have to go to God and say, oh, I need $10,000 in my bank today, Lord. Really? He said, really? And I know we hear people say, declare and decree it. Call it out. Speak it. We hear all those cliche things. But when you get into the presence of God, it's not about your emotions and your feelings. It's about getting into his presence. How do you get into his presence? Through prayer. Simple. Praying. Just praying. Getting in his presence. Because if you open up your mouth and you start praying for him and praying to him, he's going to come into the presence of where you are. He's going to do it. He's not going to ignore you. Isn't that wonderful that we know we got somebody who won't ignore us? Because we know humans, praise the Lord, they will ignore you. They will not answer their phone. They won't answer the text. And some of them, if you go ring the doorbell, they won't answer their door. But the Jesus, the God that we serve, we need to have prayer time with him all day long. Now, I'm going to go to the Word of God, because you know I always back up what I share with you with the Word of God. And I'm going to read from the English Standard Version. I'm going to read 1 Thessalonians 5, 16 through 18. Again, that's 1 Thessalonians 5, 16 through 18. And I'm reading out of the English Standard Version Bible. Here is what it says. Rejoice always. Pray without ceasing. I'm going to repeat that. Pray without ceasing and give thanks in all circumstances. So his word is telling us what he wants us to do with prayer, right? His word is telling us what his expectations is of us with prayer. He says to pray without ceasing. That's what he say. I'm reading you the word of God. He says to pray without ceasing. Now, a lot of people get this scripture a little overboard. I'm going to just make it simple. Just have some breath prayers throughout the day. He doesn't expect you to use your whole 24 hours and just open up your mouth and pray and do nothing else. Come on, we got to keep it real. But throughout the day, you can remember him, remind him that you know who he is, that you love him, that you thank him. You know, you can just stop in your tracks, riding down the street. I know when I go to Starbucks, standing in the Starbucks line, sometimes I say, Lord, I sure appreciate you allowing me to be able to get to Starbucks. I pray about it. I talk to God about everything. Most people think I'm crazy, and I'm okay with that, because at the end of the day, my mission is to be going to glory. Okay, so I'm sharing this with you Ask yourself the question when you get off, what time do you pray? And remember, I read 1 Thessalonians 5:16 through 18, where he tells us exactly what he wants us to do. It's amazing how God tells us what he wants us to do, and we just bypass it. So he's telling us right here. He says, rejoice always. Pray without ceasing. Give thanks in all circumstances. Not the good circumstances. Not just the bad circumstances. Not just when you feel like a circumstance. Not just when you want some circumstance. He say all. Capital A-L-L. Praise the Lord. So I hope this has blessed you today. And you know, I always have to take us out in a song. I always have to take us out in something to sum up what has been taught today. I pray that you were blessed. And I want you to remember one thing. Let nothing good or bad interrupt your consistent prayer life. Be blessed. Yeah. Amen. Thank God for joining me today. And this is the moment you all been waiting for. Y'all have a great day. Hey, Elsie, thank you for joining me. My auntie, CC Winans. Yo, CC, drop that verse. You think you can pray without mistake, but I know it's the only way you can make it better. God bless today. Enjoy the rest of your afternoon. Situations get too much for you to take, and you feel